Okay, so of course I think about the conspiracy behind all of it. Like, okay, why? What do they gain from this besides the gun control push? Yeah. But also, Hispanics are starting to vote
Republican
and conservative. They specifically targeted a school in an area that is majority Hispanic. Yeah, it's essentially right. Mexico is what it is. Yeah. And they went specifically for a Hispanic district, murdered 19, of course, if this was like, you know, a false flag or he was MK Ultra, there was a reason behind this because, you know, they're watching as those Hispanics are starting to lean more conservative and these people are crazy. Midterms are coming up and there's no limit to how far they'll go.
There's no limit
to how far they'll go to change the public narrative on things. And, you know, so I think there was it was multifaceted. Of course, it was a federal operation in order to implement gun control. Now, even the GOP is fighting for it.
Fox News
is calling for it. Not one inch. Do not give them one inch because they'll take the whole thing. It is a warning now, and I know it's very sad, and I know it's awful, but also, like, all this stuff is organized and operated.
That's a sick-ass white woman. Put up her picture. Laruen Witzke, Delaware's GOP U.S. Senate nominee from 2020, said this about the Uvalde killing of 19 children and members of the faculty. That's what she said. She says this was an operation by the federal government to simply make Hispanics who are voting Republican afraid to vote. And it was set up by the federal government in order to create gun control legislation in America. This is a far-right political activist. However, she has significant mainstream support. She is anti-LGBTQ and she promotes QAnon. Now, let me tell you why I bring this sick individual to your attention, as well as the person who was with her. Both of them are sick as hell. This is a national tragedy, right? Children being shot, children being killed. We all should agree. This is tragic. This individual actually has Republican support. She has Republican endorsers. She has significant Republican connections. Do you think any Republican is going to come out against her and say, listen here, Laruen Witzke, our party has no place for your rhetoric. What major leader is going to say this against her? Do you think McConnell will? How about Donald Trump? Maybe Matt Gaetz? Anybody? Lindsey Graham? Tim Scott? No one. Not one of them will speak up for children when somebody in their own tribe is willing to say something this egregious and irresponsible. Those children are dead. Those family members are grieving. Those are real funerals being held every day. And this person gets a platform to spew this kind of evil hatred. And no one in her own party has the backbone to challenge her. This is the state of the conservative movement in the United States of America. Kyla, thoughts on this?
You can really see the depravity of this individual. The fact that she has an image of the shooter in the background with different effects on it. The fact that she put forth this insane conspiracy theory instead of looking at the situation for what it was. Children have died because of policy enacted by the right of this country. Like, this woman is completely sick. And you're absolutely correct. The fact that the party will not stand against her shows us what kind of people they really are. They don't care. They think this is a joke. They think this is a game. And as long as they can profit from it, they will continue to let these kind of things happen and continue to put forth these insane conspiracy theories in order to distract from the real issues that this country is facing.
That's right. They have mastered 3Ds, duck, dodge, deny, and deflect. You have to remember over 90% of Americans are for universal background checks. The vast majority of NRA members are for universal background checks. They can't even get that part right on the Republican side because they are beholden not to the majority of Americans, not even to the majority of the members of the NRA, but to the majority of the money connected to gun manufacturers in this country. And I have to say this, if you are against universal background checks for gun ownership in this country, that means you want people who should not have guns to have them. That's what that means. That's all that means. If, for example, if you were against people having a license to drive, that means you are okay with unlicensed drivers. This is not rocket science. If you do not want criminal background checks for gun ownership, you want criminals to own guns, period.